Hey everyone, my name is Kajal and welcome to another tutorial with Webots. In today's tutorial, we will build our own differential drive robot in the Webots simulation. And without further ado, let's get into it. Let's start with a new project. So I'm going into Wizards, New Project Directory. Continue. Let's call the project diff drive robot. Continue. Select the add a rectangular arena. Continue. Done. So we have our rectangular arena, which is floor and four walls. Next, let's start creating our robot. We'll use the plus sign to start creating our robot. Go into base nodes, robot, add. Usually I first create the body, but to ensure I can move my body, I'm going to actually add a transform node. So click the plus sign under children, base node, and then select transform, add. Under transform, go into children, and now we will start creating our body. Because robot is already a rigid body, we're just gonna create a shape directly. Select shape, add. Under shape in the geometry, we will define the shape of our robot. Cylinder, add. Now let's give it a shape. Let's give it a height of 0.08, that's 8 centimeters, and a radius of 0.045. Next, let's add appearance, base node, PBR appearance, add. Under appearance, in base color, let's give it a blue body. We'll increase the roughness to 1 and metalness to 0. Now when you add an object, it is centered at 000, which means half the body is below the floor. So let's raise it above the floor, which is why we added the transform node. Under translation, in Y, make it 0.04. Now this brings our body right at the floor. We want to add a little bit of space. So let's increase it by 15, which is 1.5 centimeters, making it a total of 0.0415. Let's hit save. Now we want to reuse this for bounding object. Bounding object is what makes our object collidable. So click on transform and under definition, call it body and hit enter. Now when we go to bounding object and double click under use, we are able to see body. So we'll simply add it. And as you can see, now we have a bounding object of the same shape. Next, let's give it physics. Add and save. So that's our main body. Now let's add some wheels. Now to add wheels and make sure they are connected, we are going to use hinge joints. So click on body transform, plus base node and hinge joint. This allows us to create a connection between our robot body and our wheels. Under hinge joint for joint parameters, click hinge joint parameters. Now with our wheels, we are also going to add motors. This will allow us to turn our wheels. So double click on device and add rotational motor. Next, we will name this motor. This will make it easy for us to call this motor from our code. Let's call it motor 1. Hit enter. Next endpoint. This is where we will put our wheel. So double click on endpoint. Base node. Give it a rigid body. We will select solid and click add. We'll go under children. And select shape. Click add. Under geometry, double click or use the plus sign. And let's select a cylinder for our wheel. Now let's change the size. Let's give it a height of 0.01 and a radius of 0.025. Now we can't see our wheel because it's actually hidden inside the body. One way to check that is simply raise the wheel, and as you can see, it's visible now. So let's start by first rotating the wheel. Now we want our wheel to go on the side. Since our robot body has a radius of 0.045, that is how we will change our X to bring it to the side. Next, let's bring it back to the ground. Now again, this is halfway inside the floor. So let's bring it up. And there we have our wheel. Now when you change the location of your wheel, you need to change the anchor position of your hinge joint to ensure that your motor runs in the way you want. It's the same transformation as your endpoint. Now let's give it a nice appearance. So double click on appearance, select PBR appearance. Now let's give our wheels a red color. Change roughness to 1. Metalness to 0. And let's save this shape for reuse. So let's call it wheel. Next, the bounding object. We'll simply reuse the shape wheel. Lastly, let's add physics, which is simply the physics. For reusing this physics, let's call it wheel physics. And let's save our work. So that's one wheel. Similarly, we will add a second wheel. Select plus, base node. Hinge joint, click add. Under joint parameters, double click and select hinge joint parameters. Under device, let's add a motor. Make sure to name the motor. Let's call it motor 2. Let's add a wheel at our endpoint. Let's reuse the same wheel. And then let's transform this on the other side. So this time it will be minus 0.045. 0.025, and you can see it here on the other side. I by mistake changed the transformation. We'll change it in a second. So let's make this 1.57. And there we go. So as before, remember to change the anchor point as well. This is going to be minus 0.045 and 0.025. We'll let's hit save. Lastly, also do the bounding object. Again, we're going to reuse the same wheel. For physics, we're going to reuse wheel physics. And let's save our work. To make a robot look nice, let's add some eyes. I'm going to rotate our robot so that we can see the front side. Let's add a base node of solid. Let's add a child node of shape. Under shape, let's go in geometry and select a box. Let's have the size of 0.005. Let's give it an appearance of PBR. Matching the wheel, let's make the eyes red as well. Making roughness equal to 1 and metalness equal to 0. Save our work. We can't see it right now because it's hidden inside the robot body. So let's move it. Let's give it a translation of 0.015 in x direction, 0.07 in y direction, and 0.045 in z direction. So there you can see it, a little eye. Let's save it. Let's call our shape an eye so we can reuse it. I'm not going to give it a bounding object because it will add to the collision computation and it's not necessary. Let's add a second pair of eye by creating another solid node. We can simply reuse the shape we had last time, which we saved as an eye. Let's translate this into the negative 0.015, 0.07 in y direction, and 0.05 in z direction. Let's hit save, and there we have it, two little eyes. So there you have it, a simple differential drive robot in Webots. Next week, let's learn how to write a controller so we can drive our robot forward. We'll also learn how to turn our robot in place and turn while driving forward. I used one of the Webots world as inspiration to make this robot. I'll add the link in the description below along with all the other useful resources. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like, and if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.